Demand for copper and other metals has driven world prices through the roof in the last couple of years. And for the few who ply the old-fashioned trade of the coppersmith, high metals prices, along with mass production, are giving them a beating.
It is a dying art. It used to be used a lot in the brewing industry, in the Navy, building boats, and that's been superseded by stainless steel.
Part artist, part tradesman, Peter Pankovich has made a life and a business out of bending and beating metal, especially copper.
It's just the challenge of shaping, of understanding the discipline to shape and to form it. It's a material that you can't cut corners with, you can't take any shortcuts. If you don't follow a rigid way of working with the stuff, you won't get the result that you want. You definitely don't want to make mistakes with it, no.
He started Rivendale Copper in 1977 after emigrating to Australia. And he's now one of only a handful of artisan coppersmiths making an eclectic range for high-end customers.
It can be small items from copper lamps, copper cookware, saucepans and fry pans, planters, water features in copper for gardens. A lot of the business has been making range hoods and also canopies over bay windows. It goes up to quite large items, the roofing, wall cladding on buildings, commercial and domestic. I wouldn't say it's that lucrative. No, I don't think you'd ever get really rich on it. But I've managed to support myself and my family for the last 20, 25 years, reasonably well, I suppose.
Turnover is hard to predict.
It varies a lot from year to year. It's been as high as 150,000, 160. It's been as low as 80 or 90,000. Probably a gross profit margin would be between 40 and 60%, I suppose. I normally try and aim for between $60 and $80 an hour.
His biggest challenge is finding the next job.
I do have a few regular contacts, architects and builders. Probably Yellow Pages would bring in 60 or 70% of the work. The internet is bringing in more interstate work, where people are seeing me that they wouldn't normally see me.
An apprentice is a luxury he can't afford, but the solo nature of the business means he frequently turns down jobs.
I get quite a few inquiries for large work. The quotes often run to $50,000, $60,000, $70,000. If I had the luxury of time, I could probably do them.
Work in colour bond and stainless steel is keeping the business going.
The copper work, it's fairly regular, but I don't suppose it would be more than about 20 or 30% of the business today, and especially in recent years with the increase in metal prices. Oh, it's definitely had an impact. Somebody deciding on whether they want a bay window canopy or a range hood, or they'll often go for stainless steel or colour bond or even a powder coated finish rather than using copper.
Well, this seems to be the right finish and the right gauge.
I think it just means that there's a few more jobs that we quote that you don't get.
His creativity extends beyond the workshop.
I try and paint 2 or 3 hours a week in the evenings, and if the weather's nice, we go out on the weekend for a couple of hours. It's a little bit like working with copper. If you're not in the zone, if you're not completely involved in what you're doing, it doesn't work. And it does tend to involve you and engage you completely, as does working with copper. Although I can guarantee the result from the copper work is usually a lot more reliable than the result from the watercolours.
As he looks toward retirement, he can see the coppersmith is an endangered species.
It's not a classified trade anymore, so it's very hard to say who's actually doing it. There are a lot of firms doing large copper cladding and roofing on commercial buildings, but I don't think you'd call them coppersmiths. I think I'll be able to see it through until I decide to give it away.